Hey, Trail Riders, welcome back to the Daily Ride. I hope you guys are doing well. Today we're going to wrap up this great week. I know it's been a tough week, but we have forgiveness from God. God has sent Jesus to take all of our punishment, so and if you would receive it, you would receive in that the forgiveness of sin, past, present, and future. But we're going to be talking today about another kingdom. And our scriptures that get us through the Bible in a year are Genesis 24, 55, through chapter 26, verse 11, Psalm 9, 1 through 6, Proverbs 2, 6 through 8, and Matthew 9, 18 through 38. Again, we're going to be talking about another kingdom. The focal scripture today will be Matthew 9, 35. It says, "Then Jesus went into all the towns and villages, teaching in the synagogues, preaching the good news of the kingdom, and healing every disease and every sickness." While we focus our thoughts on the kingdom of God, we must not forget that there exists another kingdom, the kingdom of our enemy, the kingdom of Satan. The Bible shows us that in the ages past, there was just one kingdom, the kingdom of God. But through the rebellion of an angel named Lucifer, known as Satan, another kingdom was established over which the prince of the darkness rules. Every person since Adam, with a single exception of Jesus Christ, comes under the dominion of Satan, and is, in fact, classified as a citizen of the devil's kingdom, Ephesians 2, 1 and 2. When through conversion, we become followers of Jesus, when we become citizens of the kingdom of God, Colossians 1, 13. Once we receive this new citizenship, whether we realize it or not, we are thrust into the front line of an age-long conflict which has existed between God and Satan. And we become participators in the Almighty's plan to bring Satan's defeat and to bring the universe once again under the control of God and His kingdom. Standing as we do on the cutting edge between the kingdom of God and the kingdom of Satan, the Almighty has given us the most powerful weapon of all the armories of heaven. That is the weapon of prayer, the most underutilized weapon that we hold in our arsenal. Our citizenship in God's kingdom entitles and enables us to pray, "Thy kingdom come." And when we say with sincerity and trust, those words spell out every time they are spoken the ultimate triumph of the kingdom of God. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Our Father, we are utterly amazed when we realize you have not only taken me out of Satan's kingdom, but you're using me and my prayer when it is in line with your pattern to demolish his kingdom and reestablish yours. Help me, help us participate with all of our might. And it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hey guys, for further study on this subject, look at Ephesians 1, 17 through chapter 2, verse 7, Ephesians 6, 1, 2 Corinthians 4, 4, and 2 Corinthians 11, 3, and keep these two questions in mind. What is Christ's position? 2, what is our position? God bless you guys. I hope you'll have a great weekend. I hope you'll keep following me here on the Daily Ride, and I hope to see you on the next Trail Ride.